click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about what is lauriprostate acid as well as lauriprostate base, and in that case we have also did what is conjugated acid as well as what is conjugated base. And for that, now let me explain to you that while giving an example of lauriprostate acid and lauriprostate base, we have mentioned that the H2O was acting like a base as well as it was acting like an acid. So this makes the water to be amphoteric in nature. So what is amphoteric? Let us talk about it. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about what is amphoteric nature of water and why the water is being showcasing this kind of nature. So amphoteric are basically those substances which can act like acid as well as which can act like base depending on to which they have been reacting. So for example, if we are talking about a reaction with HCl and water, so this is the thing that we have did already, but let me explain you with the help of this thing. So if HCl is the one that is reacting with water, that is H2O, so it will form, that is H3O plus along with that of Cl minus. So if you observe in this case, that is the H plus has a tendency to give its proton, because in this case we know that is according to electronegative, but also we could say that the Cl minus is the one, the chlorine atom is the one which is more electronegative, and that will make the hydrogen more electropositive, and that's the reason that in HCl, when it has been dissolved in water, it could easily donate its H plus ion to the respective substance. So in this case we could see that that the HCl, that is it has been donating its H plus ion to the H2O, so as to form it as H3O plus. So therefore we could say that this is basically acting as acid. While talking about H2O, which has accepted the H plus ion so as to form H3O plus, it has been acting like a base. But meanwhile, if we say that while forming a reversible reaction, we could say that this H3O plus will give its electron or will give its proton to Cl minus so as to form HCl, so that this Cl minus can be converted into HCl and it will itself convert it into H2O. So therefore this is the one which has capacity to donate electrons, so that's the reason that this will act like an acid, while this will act like a base. But if we observe, that is this H3 plus, it has been formed because of this base has accepted the H plus ion, so that is the reason that then only it has formed into H3O plus. So that's the reason that we could say that this H3 plus is basically the conjugated acid of the base, that is H2. So and we could say that for this Cl minus, so this Cl minus is been that is it will again it will accept the H plus ion from that of the H3O plus, making this to form as, that is HCl. So therefore if HCl is a acid and Cl minus is base, so therefore we could say that this two are a conjugated acid. So HCl is a conjugated acid of the Cl minus, as well as we could say that Cl minus is basically the conjugated base for the acid HCl. So therefore we could name it as we have did earlier also. So therefore this is acid one, while this is the base that is formed because of it, and this is base two because of which the acid has been formed, or vice versa we could say anyway, because this is a reversible reaction that we are talking about. So now in this case, because H2O is acting like a base, so this is the main thing that we are going to talk about. So therefore it is acting like a base. And talking about the next kind of process, suppose in this case, like if I'm talking about another reaction where NH3 is reacting with H2O so as to form basically NH4 plus, that is I could say in this way, that is NH4 plus OH minus. So in this case, if we observe, then we'll get to know, that is if this NH3 is the one which is accepting the hydrogen from the H2O so as to form NH4 plus. So that's the reason that if it accepts the hydrogen, then according to lauriprostate theory, we could say that this is acting like a base. So then only it would form NH4 plus. And while meanwhile that H2 is the one that will donate its electron to the NH3 so as to form OH minus. So therefore this is acting like an acid over here. But meanwhile, while taking the proton from the NH3, but meanwhile, while taking a proton, the NH3 has been converting into NH4+. So now this NH4+ has capacity to donate its proton to its OH- to the other substance. So therefore, this will be acting like a base. Actually, it would act like acid. And this would act like a base because this is the one that will accept the H+ ion. And that is the reason that we could say that in this case, we could say that the base, that is NH3, has been converting into, that is NH4, forming this to be known as the conjugated acid of the base NH3. While talking about this acid, that is H2, it has been forming, that is OH-, basically forming this to be known as the conjugated acid of the base OH-. And we could see that there is a difference between the H proton, that is H2O, and this OH- has a proton difference of H+. And talking about this NH3 and NH4+, even this will have a difference of a proton, that is H+. And that is the reason that these two are basically the conjugated acid base pair. But if you observe that in this case, the H2O is the one that has been acting like an acid, but earlier it was acting like a base. So that is the reason that H2 is the one that can act like an acid also, that will can act like a base also, depending on with whom it has been reacting or with whom it has been associated. So now this is the one or this is the theory behind that it behaves like an acid also as well as the base also. And not only when you are talking about that is water, but there are also certain molecules or certain ions, they act like amphoteric in nature, or they are behaving like amphoteric. So that kind of certain atoms or that kind of certain molecules that are not water, but they also behave like amphoteric in nature, and those are basically the few examples that I'm going to showcase in this case. That is HCO3-. Talking about the next one, that is HPO4-, and that is HSO4-. So these are certain ions, they can exhibit amphoteric, or they are exhibiting amphoteric in nature. The reason behind that is they have the capability to either lose a proton, or they have the capability to accept one proton. So as you could see that overall they have a minus charge, so therefore they can accept H+ ion. So that is the reason while accepting H+ ion, they are acting like a base. They will act like a base. While donating the H+ ion, as we could see over here, there is the presence of hydrogen atom, so therefore they will act like acid. So therefore this kind of ions or this kind of molecules that I have mentioned over here, they can act like acid also, as well as they can act like base, similar to that of water. So that makes this to be behaving like amphoteric in nature, and they are amphoteric in nature. So that's it, friend. I want to explain about the amphoteric nature of the water, and meanwhile we have also discussed about this things, and I hope you have liked this video, and I hope you will share this video with the friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.